our student learning expectations. Okay, so a Franciscan Montessori Early School student is a spiritually aware person. And then there are three things that we want to think about. We're talking about spiritually aware people. Someone who demonstrates a love of God that is respectful of their beliefs, who nurtures the spirit within themselves and their community, and shares their respect for themselves and for others. Does anyone have any examples of maybe where they've seen that in our community or in their own lives? Jennifer, go ahead.
Well, I really appreciate how hard the cleaning crew in the humanities room works. They are in there for the full 15 minutes and really demonstrate a respect for themselves and for everybody that uses that room by really thoroughly cleaning it. So the sweepers are awesome. They actually flip on the rugs up, sweeping under the rugs. The table cleaners are scouring the tables and getting the chairs out of the way. The vacuumer is working hard to suck up everything. I really appreciate the group that cleans the humanities room.
Thanks, Jennifer. Any other examples? David, go ahead.
Yeah, so like a really cool example of being spiritually aware is I am Armenian Orthodox and sister is Catholic, but we still share very interesting conversations.
Cool. Thanks, David. Anyone else? Okay. So Franciscan Montessori Earth School students are also independent learners who open pathways for exploration and collaboration. Who demonstrate awareness of responsibilities and opportunities beyond the classroom, and who seek to become thriving young adults. Does anyone have any examples of that from, go ahead, Addie.
One way that I seek to become a young adult is by time management and a balanced life between classwork and my personal life.
Cool, thanks, Addie. Anyone else? Go ahead, Portia.
When it comes to talking about like thinking about learning, people who are in my Spanish class may have seen once or twice, but they sort of like show me Chinese lessons. I have some Chinese capabilities and I've done some of the lessons that tell people how to help people with someone's benign insult. But Kaya here, the name of Kaya, actually reached out to me and was like, hey, I'd be interested in doing like more robust Chinese language learning. And I was like, great, I'm not a teacher, but I'll try my best.
I saw one of your lessons too. It was cool to see how many people were excited about both Spanish and learning Chinese. That was great. Max, go ahead.
I got like a snowboard class for Sunday on like the winter. But that means I have to like do my homework on Saturday. That's like showing like responsibility and opportunity.
Cool. That's a good example. Yeah, I kind of end up having to do the same thing, Max. If I want to go take a play day or something like that, I got to make sure I get all my work done first. So yeah, that's cool that you're already thinking about that. Okay, so have you had a chance to go snowboarding yet this year? Have they opened up the runs yet?
Not yet.
I know there's a bunch of snow on the hill, though. I see it when I'm driving home here, so it should be a good year. All right. Anyone else have any examples? Jennifer, go ahead.
I had fun yesterday at lunch from 12:30 to 1. A big group of students volunteered to step up and help plan the Greek and Roman fair. And it's so much more fun when the students do it. And you had some really great ideas, and now I can go to the other building and make sure everything's confirmed. But I was really happy with the number of students who were throwing out great ideas, and that kind of demonstrates an awareness of an opportunity to learn outside of the classroom. So I appreciate all of you. Thank you.
Thanks, Jennifer. Any other thoughts or anyone else? Okay. Go ahead, Portia.
Yeah, I know I already talked, but I just wanted to tell everyone about how awesome the art and organic ones are, because we're actually like getting up and doing things, and it's really cool. I mean, it's nice to meet in space to share my same interests. So I'm just saying, if you're in a club, 10,000%, I recommend at least showing up once. They're really
lucky. Was the origami club where the dragon that was smaller than a penny got made?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was cool. Awesome. I was pretty impressed. All right, great. So a Franciscan Montessori school student is also a person of integrity who fosters respect, social justice, and equality among all members of their community, who takes responsibility for their own actions and respects the rights of others, and who takes responsibility for their stewardship of the earth. Anyone have any examples of how they've seen that in our community? Go ahead, Kaya.
So I actually have
weekend, and it was actually like really loud, you know, there was music playing. But I had like a child of friends, it was like a group of people that I hang out with during the wedding. But we couldn't really hear anything, and I know one of my friends was trying to talk, so I just offered, like, do you want to go outside? Like, I listen to your conversation, we'll go outside and I can hear you better.
Mm-hmm.
And afterwards, after the wedding, she pulled me over and she thought it was really sweet that I just offered to go outside.
That's awesome. Good job. Oliver, go ahead.
I was just sitting in my house the other day, and I saw someone walking by my house picking up trash, and I just thought that was cool.
Awesome, yeah, that's cool. Just someone in the neighborhood?
Yeah.
Right on. Any other examples? Being a person of integrity. David, go ahead.
You know, like, it was super cool. I saw someone, a person of integrity. My little sister, some of you may know, she's 2 years old,
yeah.
And she took something, I forgot what it was, from my room. And I came up to her and I was like, did you take it? And she's like, yeah, and she gives him back.
So your 2-year-old sister Melanie is already a person to take it.
Yeah.
I like it. Well, it's nice of you to be patient with you, David. That's cool. All right, any other examples anyone has? All right, thanks everybody. Let's move on to community business.